This video will guide you through the installation procedure for the SRAM Eagle AXS Transmission System. For a full list of tools and supplies, review the user manual at sram.com/service or find it linked in the video description below. SRAM Eagle AXS Transmission installation is unlike any system before, in which we prepare each component off the bike using details of your bike. Loosely hang the components in place, then tighten the components in a specific sequence. Installation is easier than ever, but totally new, so please complete the installation and setup in the order shown. Before we prepare any components, consult AXS Web at www.sram.com or use the SRAM AXS app to determine the following preparations: chain length size, setup key position, and setup cog. To install the Eagle transmission cassette and dub cranks, review the video linked in the upper right corner or consult the user manual at sram.com/service for more information. Position the clamp or right bridge in the right handlebar position. Install the pod controller with the pointed tip aligned with the open slot in the clamp. Loosen the clamp bolt if necessary. Loosely install the pod controller on the handlebar. Adjust the position to rider preference. Tighten the bolts. Install a charged SRAM battery into the derailleur. Press and hold the AXS button on the rear derailleur until the green LED blinks slowly. Then release. Press and hold the AXS button on the controller until the green LED blinks quickly. Then release. Press and release the AXS button on the derailleur to end the pairing session, or wait 30 seconds for the session to time out. The pairing process does not need to be repeated when batteries are removed or replaced. Count down on a new full-length T-type chain to the number of chain links determined by the calculator or app, or use the T-type chain sizing tool included with the chain printed manual. Use an approved chain breaker tool to break the chain at the inner link. Use a small flathead screwdriver to remove the setup key from the derailleur. Adjust the setup key to the position callout for your bicycle. Install the setup key into the derailleur so the notch is aligned with the corresponding letter, A or B. Failure to position the setup key correctly will result in an inaccurate chain gap, poor shifting performance, and may even damage your derailleur and/or bicycle frame. Press the top button on the controller to shift the derailleur into the fully outboard position. Alternatively, press and release the AXS button on the derailleur to move the derailleur outboard one position at a time until it's fully outboard. Press the bottom button on the controller to shift the unmounted derailleur into the setup cog position, 21 tooth or 24 tooth, as determined in AXS Web or the AXS app. Shift 5 times from full outboard position for the 21 tooth cog, or shift 6 times for the 24 tooth cog. Alternatively, press the AXS button on the derailleur twice quickly to move the derailleur inboard one position at a time until it's in the setup cog position. The universal derailleur hanger must be removed from the frame before derailleur installation. Turn the UDH bolt clockwise to remove it from the hanger threads. The UDH bolt is left-hand threaded. To loosen the bolt, turn clockwise. Remove the frame-specific UDH washer along with the UDH bolt. Rotate the UDH hanger backward to unseat the hanger from the pocket. Remove the UDH from the frame. For split pivot frames, pay attention to not lose any washers between seat and chainstays. Remove the mount bolt and bushing frame insert from the derailleur. Clean the frame to remove any grease or debris. Install the bushing frame insert from the outside with the black side facing outwards into the hangerless interface. For split pivot frames, reinstall any washers between the seat and chainstays. Before proceeding, make sure the cage assembly is fully tightened onto the derailleur body. Apply grease to the mount bolt threads and shaft. Hang the transmission derailleur with the full mount sliding over the hangerless interface and bushing frame insert. Install and tighten the mount bolt clockwise to snug. Loosen the mount bolt counterclockwise one full turn. Rotate the derailleur cage forward until the lock icon on the cage clears the setup key button. Press the button to lock the cage in the extended position. The transmission is spring-loaded and will return to the cage open position rapidly. Keep fingers clear of pinch points. Apply grease to the through axle threads before axle installation. Install the through axle and wheel according to the manufacturer's instructions and tighten to snug. Loosen the through axle bolt counterclockwise one full turn. Stop. Verify the chain has been cut to the proper size, the transmission derailleur is shifted into the setup cog, and the derailleur setup key is in the position as determined in AXS Web or AXS App and set up in the Prepare the Components section. E-bikes must be powered off before proceeding. Place the properly sized Eagle T-type chain on the setup cog, 21 tooth or 24 tooth, and route through the derailleur pulleys with the flat edge of the chain facing away from the cassette. Make sure to route the chain below the tab in the cage. Pull each end of the chain together and install the power lock. Press the power lock connector links together. The arrow on the outer plate must point in the direction of chain travel before locking the power lock into place. Once locked, the power lock cannot be reused if removed. Rotate the derailleur cage forward to release it from the fully extended position. Lock the cage mode button at the derailleur cage where the two key lines meet. The derailleur is spring-loaded and will return rapidly. Keep fingers clear of pinch points. Check that the two halves of the power lock are properly aligned. Use chain link pliers to lock the power lock. Alternatively, rotate the crank until the power lock is above the chain stay and confirm the two halves are still connected. Apply the rear brake and firmly push the crank arm down to lock the power lock. You should hear and feel the power lock click into place. Check the power lock by hand to make sure it moves freely. The power lock is designed for one-time use only. The power lock can only be removed with the chain link pliers and must not be reused. Install a new power lock each time the chain is installed. Reusing a power lock may result in a broken chain that could result in a crash. Before proceeding, verify the completion of all steps in the Prepare and Hang the Component sections, that the chain is properly engaged on the setup cog and chain ring, the cage is locked in the setup position, and that the bicycle suspension is uncompressed at 0% sag, unless otherwise instructed. Pull back on the lower cage of the transmission derailleur to remove slack from the chain. Continue to pull back while you rotate the crank forwards two rotations and confirm the chain stays on the setup cog. For bicycles using the 24-tooth setup cog or gear 6, make sure the chain is fully seated on the X-Sync cassette cog profile with two full crank rotations. Adjust the chain as needed. Tighten the mount bolt while continuing to pull back on the lower cage of the derailleur. Then release. If there's still slack in the chain after tightening the mount bolt, loosen the bolt and repeat the previous steps. Verify the knurled ring mark is aligned with the mark on the full mount of the derailleur. If it's not aligned, loosen the mount bolt, rotate the knurled ring so that it is touching the knurled ring stop, and repeat the previous steps. Tighten the rear axle to torque according to the frame or axle manufacturer's instructions. Release the cage from setup mode by rotating the cage forward and carefully letting it return to the unlocked position. This completes the system installation. There are no adjustment screws in this system. You must repeat the installation procedure if you change any of the following on your bicycle: chain ring size, geometry adjustment to chainstay length, or position of a lower idler pulley. Failure to repeat the installation when changing chain ring size, geometry, or position of a lower idler pulley may result in poor shifting performance and may even damage your derailleur and/or bicycle frame. Rotate the crank slowly and press the bottom button on the AXS pod controller to shift the derailleur all the way inboard. Continue to rotate the cranks and press the top button of the AXS pod controller to shift the derailleur all the way outboard. The pulleys may appear to be unaligned. They are intentionally offset to improve chain travel and direction to the chain ring. Optimize derailleur shift performance and eliminate unwanted rasping sounds by fine-tuning the derailleur position with micro-adjust. Micro-adjust affects position across all of the cogs. There is no independent adjustment for each cog. Press and hold the controller axis button while pressing a controller button. The bottom button will adjust the derailleur 0.2 mm inboard and improve shifting to an inboard cog. The top button will adjust the derailleur 0.2 mm outboard and improve shifting to an outboard cog. If you've customized shift buttons in the AXS app, micro adjustments will follow those settings. The derailleur may not appear to move. Watch for the LED to blink to confirm the derailleur executed the command. Use the SRAM AXS app as an alternative method to perform micro-adjust when the bicycle setup does not include or allow access to the shifter buttons. If you haven't already, download the SRAM AXS app, available for free in the app stores. Use the app to create your account, add your components, and customize your SRAM AXS experience. This concludes the installation procedure for the SRAM Eagle AXS Transmission System.